Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Thereafter two angels approach the deceased person, their eyes shine like lightning, their voice sounds like loud thunder, their canine teeth are as big as the horns down towards their feet, and the distance between their two shoulders could be covered only after several days of journeying. They do not even have a touch of affection and softness. However, they do not treat the mu'mineen severely. Nevertheless, their appearance alone is sufficient to scare a person. These two angels are called Munkar and Nakir. Each one of them holds such a huge and heavy hammer that if all human beings and jinnat in this world wish to lift it, they will be unable to do so. They approach the deceased person and instruct him to sit up. The person immediately sits up and the shroud falls from his head to his hips. They question him, "Who is your Rabb? What is your religion? And what is the name of your Prophet?" The person replies, "My Rabb is Allah, the one who has no partners, the sovereign master. My religion is Islam and my Prophet is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the seed of all prophets." Both the angels say, "You have replied correctly." Thereafter, they remove the walls of the grave from all sides, because of which it becomes very spacious from the top and in all four directions, the right, the left, the head, and the leg sides. Then they say to him, "Raise your head." When he raises his head, he sees a door through which Jannah appears. They say, "O friend of Allah, this is your place of abode because you obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "By the oath of that being in whose control is my life," the deceased person experiences such happiness which will not return. Then the angels tell him, "Look towards your feet." When he does so, he sees through a door of Jahannam the condition of Jahannam. The angels tell him, "O friend of Allah, you have been saved from entering this door." Again, he experiences such happiness which will not return. Thereafter, 70 doors are opened in the grave towards Jannah, from which the cool breeze and the fragrant smell of Jannah continuously blows upon him. This will be his condition until the day of Qiyamah. Now listen to the condition of the disobedient person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructs Malakul Maut, "Go to my enemy and bring his soul. I gave him everything in abundance. I showered my bounties upon him from all four sides in the world, and yet he was disobedient to me. Bring him so that I may punish him." Malakul Maut approaches him in a very frightening form. In this form he has 12 eyes. He holds a very thick and huge iron club made from the fire of Jahannam, which is with thorns. He has 500 angels under his command. They bring a large blade of copper with them. They hold big and huge burning charcoals of Jahannam in their hands and whips of blazing fire. As soon as Malakul Maut approaches him, he hits him with a thick and huge iron club, the thorns of which penetrate into every vein and fiber of his. Then he pulls it out. The other angels begin to strike his face and hips with their whips, causing him to become unconscious. Thereafter, they extract the soul from the toes of his feet and stop it in his heels and begin whipping him. Then they extract it from the heels and stop it in the knees. They extract the soul from hair and stop it at various places in order to cause pain and difficulty. So meaning they extract the soul from the head side and they stop it at various places in order to cause pain and difficulty to him for a longer period. They stop the soul in the stomach, and from here they extract it until it reaches the chest. The angels then place the copper and the blazing charcoals of Jahannam under his chin. Thereafter Malakul Maut says, "O accursed soul, come out and proceed to that Jahannam," which has been described as follows: "In such a fire, boiling water and a cloud of black smoke, which will not be cooled, nor will it get comfort. Rather, it will be very painful." Ayats of Surah Waqi'a. Then when his soul is extracted from the body, it says to the body, "May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punish you. You always hastened me in the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you were always slow in obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have destroyed both of us." The body speaks to the soul in the very same manner. The earth upon which he used to disobey Allah ta'ala curses him, and the army of Shaitan runs quickly to their leader Iblis to give the good news that one person has reached Jahannam. When his dead body is placed in the grave, the ground closes in upon him, so that one side of his ribs penetrate into the other. Black serpents and snakes are let loose upon him, which begin biting him from the nose on one side and the toe of the feet of the other side, until they meet in the center. Then Munkar and Nakir, whose appearance was already mentioned, approach him. They question him, "Who is your Rabb? What is your religion? Who is your prophet?" After each question, he expresses his ignorance. On this reply, he is hit so severely with a club that the sparks of the club spread all over the grave. Then he is ordered to look up. He looks up through an open door of Jannah at the gardens and beauty of Jannah. The angels tell him, "O enemy of Allah, had you been obedient to Allah, this would have been your abode." The Prophet ﷺ says, "By the oath of that being in whose control is my life," at this time he experiences such regret which he never experienced before. Then a door of Jahannam is opened and the angels say to him, "O enemy of Allah, this is your abode because you disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." Thereafter, 77 doors of Jahannam are opened upon his grave, from which hot winds, smoke, etc. blows. The Muhaddithin questioned the chain of narration of this hadith, but its subject matter is corroborated by many other narrations, especially the narrations of Hazrat Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, which appears in Kitabul Janaiz, in Book of Funerals, and in the chapter which confirms and establishes the punishment of the grave in Mishkat al-Masabih. If anyone wants to see its translation, you should consult the Kitab Mazahir al-Haq. This scene should constantly be remembered, since it is a very severe matter. Such happenings have been mentioned in the ahadith excessively. For the sake of brevity, only one hadith was translated. Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha says, "There is destruction for the sinful inmates of the grave. Upon them black serpents will be let loose. These serpents will bite them, starting from the head on one side and from the feet on the other side, until they meet in the middle. This is the punishment of Barzakh, the period between death and resurrection, which the Quran has described as, 'And before them lies a Barzakh until the day they are resurrected.'" For this reason, Hazrat Uthman radiallahu anh used to weep so bitterly when mention was made of the grave that his blessed beard used to get wet, as was explained before. Even though Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is sinless, yet the du'as of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam are filled with seeking refuge from the punishment of the grave, to teach people to seek protection from it. For this reason, there is a saying of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which was mentioned previously, that were it not for the fear of leaving your deceased unburied, I would have made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to let you hear the punishment of the grave. As a matter of fact, these punishments are the demand of justice, for the human being has been sent into this world for the sake of ibadat, only for the sake of ibadah only. And together with all the physical and material bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah has explicitly shown that his coming into this dunya is solely for the ibadat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah mentions, "I have not created the jinn and the humankind, but so that they worship me. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ." May Allah ta'ala give us all the tawfiq to worship him, our purpose of our creation. And may Allah protect us from a bad ending and from the punishment of the grave. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.